Hi there. Well, let's talk about the equinox now. We are almost there here in this lovely evening here in California around September. And I wanted to talk about the lines on the globe, which are true places on the planet that have certain unique features, such as the amount of daylight that we have. Here at the equinox, we're going to come up to equal daylight and nighttime. So at the moment, half the world is illuminated and the other half is not illuminated. This would be the equinox. You can see that the axis of the Earth pretty much is perpendicular to the circle of illumination. So as I spin this Earth, all the Earth is getting this sunlight now in the evening. This is universal throughout the world. Let's say though it's the summertime, okay? I'm facing toward where the sun is, and right in here you can kind of see a line, the circle of illumination we call it. And as I spin the Earth, there's one spot where the sun never gets behind. Okay, so these folks up here north of the Arctic Circle are going to get 24 hours of daylight. Okay, let's turn this the other way now. Let's say this is the winter solstice. Okay, and you can kind of get a sense of, you know, here's where the circle of illumination is. And as the Earth spins around, okay, as it spins around, folks here in the Arctic, they never ever get to see any sunlight. So that's what the Arctic Circle is all about. Okay, so there's the Arctic Circle up there, and that's 66.5 degrees north of the equator. Moving on down, you go all the way to Baja here, and you see the Tropic of Cancer. What is that significant? Why is that significant? And that is on June 21st or thereabouts, that's our solstice, the summer solstice in the northern hemisphere, the sun gets directly overhead at that point. Everything north of it's never directly overhead. And between that point and the Tropic of Capricorn, we're gonna get direct rays. These are the tropics. Okay, let's just see if I can't find the Tropic of Capricorn. As I spin the Earth around, here's the Tropic of Capricorn right here. Okay, it's in Argentina. I've had the opportunity to go there. And that's where the sun's directly overhead on December 22nd or thereabouts. That's our winter, but yep, that's their summer. That's their summer solstice. So we are starting to enjoy fall here a little bit as we get toward the equinox in Northern California. And those folks in Alaska are gonna really start to see their days shorten though after the equinox. Their days currently are longer, but come the equinox and then there the day after, they've gotta go all the way from 12 and 12, 12 hours daylight, 12 hours at nighttime, to, you know, up there by the Arctic Circle, to 0 days. In other words, complete darkness. So I'm glad that I'm at 38 degrees in latitude right now on this nice evening in Northern California.